The system is broken.
It is.
But how do we fix it?
Break the rules.
Hey everybody, welcome back to TLTV. My name is Tyler, and this week we're gonna be talking about a brand spanking new TV show that my wife and I can't get enough of, New Amsterdam. Now, on the surface, New Amsterdam may seem like your typical serialized medical drama, but it is so much more, and I think that's what we love about this show. It took us so off guard by the message that it has, and it's very simple. How can I help you? And what I mean by that is this hospital is kind of in shambles, and by shambles I mean it's not being run, you know, to the highest efficiency possible. So they bring in this guy who's radicalized medicine downtown at a Chinatown medical clinic and completely turned it around. So they bring him in to do the same thing with New Amsterdam, a public hospital. What he does is completely break all the rules, change up the whole system, and focuses on the patient. Now, you would assume that all doctors focus on their patients. That's their job. That's what you do. But watching the show, you realize that, oh yeah, I guess doctors don't really focus solely on their patients. They have other things to consider, like insurance and answering to members of the board if you're the chief of cardiology and things like that. But his sole purpose to bring this hospital back to its prime is to focus on the patient.
If you can't help Gemma as a doctor, then just help her as a human being.
Am I allowed to do that?
You are now.
That's how he's changing the game. The way that this show looks at these medical issues and these medical problems that they come up with episode after episode, and it just boils it down to the basic humanity between every single problem that we encounter in our daily lives. The most powerful part of the show is that, yes, we have the major medical issues that pop up on every episode, but what we focus on normally are what I'm going to refer to as the side effects that occur on the most basic human level. Yes, we have this main problem, but what we focus on is how that problem has manifested and how it's affected those people. We're focusing on the effects. It doesn't focus on, hey, look at this bullet wound, or hey, look at this, you know, discrimination and bigotry. It focuses on, look what it's doing to the person. Look at the effect that that is having on these people. Because in the world we live in today, so much of it is desensitized. We're on our phones, we're on technology, I'm speaking to a camera right now, and I understand how frickin' batshit this must sound, but it is so desensitized, our world is these days, because we're so far removed. We don't interact with people the way that we used to. So our ability and our level of compassion and empathy is reduced dramatically. So to have this show remind us that that is such an important part of life is probably the most powerful part of this show, because it's something that the world desperately needs right now. Now, NBC knew exactly what they were doing. This show airs right after This Is Us. And if you've watched This Is Us, you know how much of an emotional powerhouse that show is in itself. And for those of you who don't know, it's really just raw. It's about family, it's very real, and it just kind of hits a very familial chord that strikes with a lot of people. I'm not gonna do a video on This Is Us because I don't wanna ruin it. Anything more that I say about that show might ruin something, so I'm just gonna leave it at that. It's a very powerful show, go and watch it. So for those of you who have cable, check out New Amsterdam. For those of you who don't, God, I hope they put it up on streaming somewhere, because this show is fucking phenomenal. It needs to be around, it needs to keep going. It's like 5 or 6 episodes in and already I'm like, this is a show that we need and needs to continue and needs to keep telling stories. Because the more we can see the humanity in other people's lives, the better off the world will be for it. Now that I'm done gushing all over this show, I just want to say thank you. Thank you to all of you who actually watch these videos. I don't do it just to get the views. I do it because I like talking about movies and TV. I love this stuff. This is my life. I'm an actor. And this is something that I love talking about because it is so powerful, these different stories that affect people in different ways and really bring us together as a community. I love talking about this stuff. So from the bottom of my heart, thank you to everyone who's been watching, and thank you to everyone who will be watching in the future. With that being said, what do you guys want to talk about? What out there right now has got you pumped? It's got you hyped? It's got you like, oh my God, this movie is incredible. Oh my God, this TV show is like the best TV show that's come out in such a long time. There's so much content out there. What are you guys watching? I want to know. Maybe I want to watch it. That's it for this week. As always, thanks again for watching and see you next time.